Welcome all of you. This is the second lecture and here I unplugged the questions from ICC 2007 and just go for the question directly. An object is placed in front of an converging lens. Converging lens means convex lens. At a distance greater than twice of the focal length of the lens. Draw a ray diagram for the formation of the image. Okay, we just follow the two rules of construction of the image. The first one, if the light ray is parallel to that of the principal axis, after diffraction it passes through the focus. Rule number two, if the light ray is passing through the optical center in the time of refraction through the lens, it will shows no deviation after refraction. We just follow these two golden rules of image construction and we will answer this question. Converging lens, that is an convex lens. Principal axis, we have to draw the geometrical attributes. Before that, before discussing anything, optical center, focus, twice of the focus, in this side also you have to draw the F and 2F, you have to point out the F and 2F on the principal axis because we have to make the sections on the incident side or on the object side. But actually the focus of the converging lens or the convex lens is on the right side. For that, where the object is placed, according to the questions, it is said the object is placed at a distance greater than that of the twice of the focal length. Somewhere here. So a ray coming out from the point capital P parallel to that of the principal axis, after refraction passing through the focus. Another ray coming out from the point P, passing through the optical center, and after refraction shows no deviation. It follows the same initial path of the ray. These two refracted rays intersect each other at the point small p. So we can say this small p is the real image of this capital P. If I draw a perpendicular from small p on the principal axis, it will intersect the principal axis at the point small q. So we can say this small pq is the image of capital PQ. The answer of this question is complete. Just they have told to draw the ray diagram, we have drawn the ray diagram. But if we want to find, if we want to know what is the characteristics of the image obtained here, then we can say PQ image is formed due to the intersection of the refracted rays. So we can say the image that is obtained, it is a real one. Number two, is it erect or inverted? The image that is obtained, is it erect or inverted? The image that is obtained, object is like this, but the image is like this, that is on the downside of the principal axis. So you can say the image that is obtained, it is an inverted one. At which position we obtain the image? Where we obtain the image? We obtain the image in between the F and 2F. So we get the image in between the focus and twice of the focus in between F and 2F. Now just think about, we can say this is the object distance. The distance of the object from the optical center of the lens is called the object distance. And the distance of the image from the optical center of the lens is called the image distance. It is greater than 2F, but it is less than 2F. What is magnification? We know that magnification equal to V by U. Here V is small, U is greater. So we can say it is less than 1. The magnification alternately can be defined as I by O, the image height to that of the object height. So it should be less than 1. From here it is clear that I is less than O. So the size of the image is less than that of the size of the object. So you can say the image that is obtained here, it is a diminished one. The size of the image is smaller than that of the object. That will do in each and every question. If we get something after answering the question, we will try to understand what we can obtain from this question and the way, we can say the ways the questions can be asked the next time in the next ICSE exams. That is also our aim and motive. So not only the answering the questions, what type of questions can be asked from that particular type of questions that we try to find out in each and every question answering. Thank you all of you.